Hello students, today we will discuss the types of operating system. The computer network has many resources such as software and hardware that are mandatory to finish the task. Generally, the required resources are file storage, CPU, memory, input and output devices, and so on. The operating system acts as a controller of all of the above mentioned resources and assign them with a specific program executed to perform the task. Hence, the operating system is a resource manager that handles the resources as user view and system view. The evaluation of the operating system is marked the programming of punch card to training machines to speak and interpret any language. Evolution of operating system since 1950 described in the below. In this video, I will discuss four major types of operating systems evaluated over the past 70 years. First one is batch operating system. Second one is time sharing operating system. Third one is distributed operating system. Fourth one is network operating system. Real time operating system. Moving to the first batch operating system in detail. The operating system is termed as batch operating because the input data are collected into batches and each batch is processed as a unit. The output is another batch that can be reused for computation. In this type of operating system, the user did not interact directly with the computer system. The user prepared a job, offline devices like punch card. Job consisted of a program, data, and some control information about the nature of the job. And finally, submitted to the computer operator. After some amount of time, the output appeared. The output consisted of the results of a program as well as dump of the final memory and register contents for debugging. To speed up processing, operator batch together jobs with similar needs and run them through the computer as a group. Thus, the programmer would leave their programs with the operator. The output from each job would be sent back to the appropriate programmer. In this execution environment, the CPU is often idle because the speed of the mechanical I/O devices are intrinsically slower than those of electronic devices. Operating system major task was to transfer control automatically from one job to the next. The operating system was always resident in memory. In batch environment, process is created in response to the submission of a job. Let us see the advantage and disadvantage of the batch operating system. Moving with the advantage first, the time required for a job to complete is predictable as the jobs are in a queue. Multiple jobs can share the systems. Reduced idle time. It is easy to process and manage large workload. Whereas moving to the disadvantages of batch operating system, zero interaction between the user and the system. Debugging is harder as the operator needs to through with the batch system, which is difficult. It is costly. If one job fails, the operating system puts the other jobs on a standby for an unknown time period. Last disadvantage is CPU is often left idle during processing as the speed of the mechanical I/O devices is slower as compared to the CPU. Now, moving to the next type of operating system, it is time sharing operating system and it is also called as multitasking operating system. The operating system performs time sharing through CPU scheduling and multi-programming. Let us study closely the process in a time sharing system. It is as follows. It is the division of CPU time for each process when more than one task are given by the user. A short duration of time is chosen for each process. Moreover, this time duration is very small in the order of 10 to 100 milliseconds. This time duration is known as time slot, either time slice or quantum. Let us take an example. Three processes, namely P1, P2 and P3 are running on the system. Now suppose that quantum is 4 nanoseconds. Now they will execute in the following manner. Process P1 will execute for 4 nanoseconds. As soon as it gets over, process P2 start executing for a duration of 4 nanoseconds. Further, when P2 gets complete, process P3 executes for 4 nanoseconds. This process continue till all the processes gets complete. In this way, only one process runs at a time, but the switching between the process is very fast. Hence, the user feels that all the processes are running at the same time. Moving to the advantage and disadvantages of time sharing operating system. Let us first begin with the advantage. Each program receives equal time to use CPU. Software duplication is difficult. CPU is no longer left idle. Whereas disadvantage of time sharing operating systems are, first one, due to multiple sharing, it is unreliable. Data integrity and security are threatened. And last disadvantage is data communication is difficult. Moving to the next type of operating system is distributed operating system. In this type of operating system, multiple CPUs are used to serve multiple processes. All the computers have their own memory unit and CPU and are interconnected and communicated with each other over a shared communication network. The processor differs in size and functions, and remote access is enabled within the devices connected to a network. The job of data processing is distributed among various processors, which makes the job more efficient. Let us understand advantage and disadvantage of distributed operating system. Advantages of a distributed operating systems are, if one system collapses, the other are not affected by it as they are independent of each other. Increased data exchange speed and reduced load of the host computer. Computation is highly fast and durable due to shared resources. It is easily scalable due to the attachment of multiple systems. And last advantage is reduced delay in the data processing. Moving to the disadvantages of a distributed operating systems. First one is, a single system failure might not affect the entire communication, but the failure of the main network can crash it. Languages used to establish distributed operating systems are not well established. And last disadvantage is, it is not readily available as it is very expensive and complex. Moving to the next type of operating system, network operating system. This operating system runs on a server, allowing it to manage data, users, groups, security, applications, and other networking functions. It allows shared access of files, printers, security applications, and other networking functions over a small private network or a LAN. Users are well aware of its underlying configuration, making it tightly coupled system. Moving to the advantages and disadvantages of network operating system. To begin with, we'll prefer advantages of network operating system first. It has stable and centralized servers that can handle security concerns well. integration of new technologies and hardware upgradation is easier. Remote server access is possible. Moving to the disadvantages of network operating systems. First one is high cost of servers. Second disadvantage is most operations could only be performed through a central location. And last disadvantage is it requires regular maintenance and updating. Moving to the next type of operating system, real-time operating system. In this type of operating system, the time required to process and respond to its input is very small. This time taken by the system to respond to an input and display the response is known as response time. This is often used when there are rigid time requirements or in control devices. This has defined time constraints for the system to run smoothly. There are two types of real-time operating system. First one is hard real-time system, and second one is soft real-time system. Let's try to learn what does it mean by hard real-time systems. It is nothing but it is a highly strict time constraint to make sure that critical tasks are completed on a time. There is limited secondary storage and the data is often stored in ROM with no virtual memory. Whereas in case of soft real-time system, they have less strict time constraint and critical tasks are given priority above others until they are completed and have limited utility. Moving to the advantages and disadvantages of real-time operating system. First, we'll see advantages of real-time operating system. More output from resources is received due to maximum utilization of devices and system. Less time is required for task shifting. It focuses more on running applications. Due to the small size of programs, they can be used in embedded systems. It is error-free. And the last advantage is the best management of memory allocation. Moving to the disadvantages of real-time operating systems. First one is very few tasks runs at the same time in order to avoid errors. The system resources are usually very expensive. Complex algorithms that are difficult to write on. It needs specific interrupt signals and device driver to respond earliest to interrupts. And the last disadvantage is thread priority can't be set as these systems don't usually switch tasks. To summarize, in this video, I have explained 5 major types of operating system with their advantages and disadvantages. We learn batch operating system, time sharing operating system, distributed operating system, network operating system, and real-time operating system, along with its advantages and disadvantages. These are the references which I have used for creating these slides. Thank you.